Hello， 大家好，我是 Alicia， 加拿大政府主策移民顧問。今個禮拜的移民最新消息呢，就同大家分享一下嘅。第一段呢，就是 Express Entry 的 draw 啦，咁樣就係呢個計呢個七月六號之後呢，就第六次嘅 draw， 就係 All Program 嘅，即係 Canadian Experience Class 啦、Federal Skill Worker 啦，同埋 Provincial Nominee 呢，就係總共9月14號2022年呢，抽咗就3250個 invitation to apply。咁最低嘅 CRS Comprehensive Ranking Score 咧就510分嘅咁樣。咁第二段消息啦，就係有一個 RCIC 咧，就係叫 Earl Blaney， 就做即係佢研究緊啊，點解咁多study permit 嘅 refusal rate 嘅咧？咁即係加拿大嘅學生簽證嗰個拒簽率咁高嘅咧？咁佢就做咗一個18頁嘅報告嘅。咁我睇咗，咁我 summarize 俾大家分享一下啦，咁樣。咁佢覺得咧有兩個原因嘅，因為咁多嘅 student permit application 係俾人哋拒簽，去到70-80% 咁高咁樣。第一個咧就係好多加拿大嘅學校咧依賴咧就係一個叫做 aggregator， 即係個 master agent 啊，嗰啲 agent 咧就好大嘅，跟住佢就即係濫收學生啊咁樣。咁啊舉個幾個例子啦，咁佢哋會有好大批嘅各地嘅10 agent 咁啊，亂咁收啲學生啦，咁樣咁啊，學生就俾咗嗰啲designated learning institute 啦，咁佢哋就為咗生意啦，咁啊就如果啲學生啊可能唔夠 quality 咧，都係 submit 俾照 submit study permit， 咁啊令到嗰個 refusal rate 就加大啦，咁樣。第二個咧就係嗰個 designated learning institute 咧，太過依賴嗰啲 agent 啦，咁啊完全係冇對呢啲學生做一個 quality 嘅 control 嘅咁樣。咁就舉個例子咧，就係2013年咧，呢啲 designated learning institute 咧就係40% 嘅學生咧就嚟住呢啲咁嘅叫做 education agent 啦。咁去到2022年咧，呢個 report 出嚟，即係啱啱出嚟嘅8月出嚟咧，就70-80% 咧就嚟自呢啲 agent 嘅，甚至有間 college 咧叫 Saint Clair 啦，佢點名嘅88% 嘅 student 咧嚟自呢啲 agent 嘅咁樣。咁佢個 report 再詳細咁樣去分析咧，就係有啲邊啲嘅 learning institute 咧，就係佢哋係加大咗嗰個海外招生嗰個 marketing budget 或者 effort 啦，咁啊對於佢個 refusal rate 咧有一個直接嘅關係嘅，咁我點咗幾間學校嘅，咁啊對呢個學生簽證嘅 refusal rate 有 negative impact 有影響嘅，就係幾間啦，就係加拿大東部嘅一個我哋 Big Four 咧有3間 Humber、Centennial 同埋 George Brown。咁啊，西岸咧有 UBC 喎，咁啊，因為佢哋收多咗海外生啦，咁嗰個 refusal rate 咧，即係嗰個 study permit refusal rate 係加大咗嘅。咁冇影響嘅咧，就係有多倫多大學啦 ，UT Seneca College 同埋 University Canada West 嘅。咁對於加大咗呢個收生海外招生個 effort 或者 marketing 嘅咧，就係對於呢個study permit refusal rate 係有。即多啲approval rate 嘅就係 UT Management School、University of Windsor 或者 University of New Brunswick College 咧，係佢哋雖然加大咗個國際招生個 effort 咧，而佢哋嗰個 student permit 嘅 application 嗰個 approval rate 係有幫助嘅咁樣。最後一段消息啦，咁啊講翻加拿大嘅 international student 嗰個國際生嗰、那個。尤其是 BC 省啦，咁啊，原來2015年咧係21% 嚟自印度嘅，而2022年咧已經增加到45% 係嚟自印度嘅，咁已經係追過咗第二大嗰個市場啦，即係中國大陸啦咁樣。咁現時咧喺 BC 咧就係有509,000個學生，即係大專院校嘅學生啦，而151個咧就係嚟自國際生嘅咁樣。咁變咗係超過咗一半咧，係 international student， 差唔多一半咧就係 international student 啦。好啦，今個禮拜就同大家分享到咁多，下次再見，拜拜。